everybody, welcome to the Comic Gamer Movie Show. My name's Deshaun, and today I am here to talk about that big news yesterday about the Ms. Marvel casting. A young and up-and-coming actress named Iman Vellani. I'm sorry if I butchered her name. Names like that are hard for me. You know, it's something that, like, it's a name that, like, if she says it enough, I'll get it. You know, it's just a name like that. Like, I'd have to hear it, but she is really a fresh face. Like, I'm talking you thought Tom Holland was a fresh face. At least Tom Holland was in that movie, The Impossibles, before. You know, no one's really seen anything from Vellani. I know I'm just saying her name wrong, but no one's really seen anything from Vellani. She's 17 years old. I believe she's 18 now. I believe she's 17 years old or 18 years old. She has no credited roles. I mean, she's been in nothing. And I don't mean that metaphorically. I mean, she doesn't even have anything on IMDb. She only has a couple pictures online of, like, official pictures that she's taken for being in anything. The only thing she's really credited for is a short that she made, I think it was, like a Canadian, film festival thing that was apparently a really damn good short. Other than that, that's all she has. Yeah, she made a short at the age of, like, 16 years old. So, think about that. What were you doing? She had a short that she directed a short that was shown at a film festival at 16 years old. So, clearly she has something going for her, but no one really knows. And all reports are coming out saying that Marvel cast her months ago. They cast her months ago. I don't know if you guys remember this. I didn't talk about this myself because it's just, you know, I don't talk about everything. Like I said, I like to have some official something or some people actually talk about it. Like, before I talk about it, I like some people that I trust to talk about it. But there was all these reports a while ago that Marvel had, like, a casting. Like, Marvel were putting out feelers and auditioning a bunch of girls. And there was some leaked videos of girls sending in audition tapes. And that Marvel had auditioned a ton of girls for this role, and now it's coming out that they casted her maybe two or three months ago. So she's been cast for quite a while. They casted her right around the same time they started to even get the directors and whatnot. So she's been actually cast as Ms. Marvel for quite a bit. It's just we're hearing about this now, which, like a lot of people, a lot of insiders have also said that it's a big deal that. The fact that she has no credits to her name, the fact that she has no acting things she can go over, means that she only could have gotten this job if she destroyed the audition. And when I hear things like that, it makes me think about Robert Downey Jr.'s audition tape. And I know I don't want to jump the gun. It makes me think about Robert Downey Jr.'s audition tape. It makes me think of, obviously Tom Holland's audition tape. It makes me think of Chris Pratt's audition tape. Like, the fact of the matter is that this job wasn't guaranteed to her, and she was in a room full of other girls, some of which probably had more credits to their name and more acting, not ability, because, I mean, clearly she must have had something, but just more notoriety, more polish. And the fact that however her audition went was so great, was so good, that Marvel said, we're going to pick her. It really bodes well. I can't wait to see what this actress does. The thing is, like, she is really a no-name. Like, we sometimes make jokes about this, but she is really a no-name. Like I said, not only does she not have credit to her name, she doesn't have any upcoming titles to her name. So, like I said, we will just have to see how this goes. But I am so happy about this because this video, and plus this video is kind of going to double down because as many of you know, and you know, some people who started following me, I really made like some of the bigger videos that I made, at least for me, you know, equivalent to for me, were my Captain Marvel videos in the recent video I did on the harassment of the Kamala Khan creator on that Marvel 616 thing. And it's just kind of ironic now talking about it because now it's kind of the two worlds merging because I've already seen a lot of people talking shit about, oh, you're shoving this down our throat, you're shoving this down our throat, this is SJW, this is SJW, that. And I've always, me and Steph have always talked about how, like, Kamala Khan, her Muslim religion is going to be a big part of her character. And it's going to be, and the smart thing is all the directors and even the writers, they got people who know what it's like to be from another country, not maybe from another country, but to have, you know, family, maybe their parents from another country and come over here. They hired a bunch of people including the directors, the Bad Boys, Bad Boys for Life, who know what it's like to come to America from a different country and you know, and have to overcome not only their own parents and what they believe, but then adjust into this new world and what America is. And they hired so many directors who know that personally. So like that gives this is gonna give the show such a more personal vibe. It's like no. These are people who understand this shit. It's not some random dude who's like, I understand how it's like to be an immigrant. No, you fucking don't. It's like, I understand. Do you? No, they got directors who actually genuinely know and are good what it's like to be that. So that already bodes well for the show, including the writing crew. That already bodes well for the show. And not to mention, like I said, this Kamala Khan is Marvel. I made a video not too long ago talking about her stock on the rise. But I really mean it, people. Like, really, you have to jump on this bandwagon. I'm telling you, Kamala Khan, Ms. Marvel, is a modern-day Spider-Man. In terms of just the character, how she is, the personality she has, she's very down-to-earth. She's a D&D player. She's a nerd. She plays World of Warcraft. She's a fucking fanboy for the Avengers and all things Marvel. She's a film fan. She's a film person. She's genuinely like, she's like a modern day Spider-Man, like in the term, and she's dealing with school and being on school on time and maybe going to prom. But then the thing that makes her so different and unique is her Muslim heritage and that aspect of it. Because then you have characters like her brother, who's like really down into like the religion, and like he's always talking about, you know, he's always worshiping and his dad. Then you got like, and I love the household she lives into, because if you know anything about like comedians have joked about this for years, and there's a couple comedians who made funny jokes about this. But there's no, like, I mean, no, but everybody's parents are different, and everybody's parents differ. But as far as I've seen, especially as portrayed in movies and in people I have known who have immigrant parents are fucking tough, dude. Because they always come with this added edge of, I work so fucking hard to get here, there is no fucking way you're gonna ruin your life. You better do this, you better do this, and you better do this. I work too hard to get here, just to get in this country. And that's kind of the angle that a lot of immigrant parents have. That's not quite her parents. Her dad sometimes can be hard, but generally speaking, he is a big teddy bear, but he does have that fucking mentality, though. He has it, like, it's not as over the top, but he does have this, like, you better go to school. You know how hard I work to get here? But like I said, like, and then there's this whole religious aspect, which I would say to her, her Muslim, you know, heritage and religion is just as important to her as being a Catholic is to Daredevil, which also adds a different spin to it. Because every once in a while, especially in that original book, she would go to, you know, one of the churches, and she'd be talking to you. I don't remember every detail about the Muslim religion, but I guess they're equivalent of a pastor. But she'd talk to them, and like she'd ask them questions, and you know, they'd tell them stories from their version. From their, you know, from their perspectives, and give her wisdom, and you know, help her grow as a kid. Literally, her Muslim religion is the same exact thing as Daredevil in the Catholic thing. So if you don't have a problem with Daredevil constantly going to the church and talking to, you know, I always forget that father's name who was there, but you do not have a problem with him going there constantly talking to him, you know, constantly talking about his religion, his Catholic religion, then you should not have a problem with her in this show. So that's, you know, that's aside the point. Honestly, it's so great to see this. Her stock is rising. She is the next big rising star. Little as I know, so many SJW people have been screaming about how, you know, SJW this and SJW that. I mean, anti-SJWs. That a lot of people don't know that Ms. Marvel is technically the best-selling comic in Marvel of the last decade in the Marvel history. Like, it's a big comic. And she is, like I said, her stock is rising. She's in the latest video game. She's probably going to be great in that. She was great in that. She really rose up in a lot of people's eyes. So I am excited for this. I am really excited for this. I can't wait to see what this actress brings to the table. It's going to change her life, man. Could you imagine that? By the way, I'm just going to take a moment to just think about this. Could you imagine being a 17-year-old, hasn't really worked on anything, and now you are about to be the lead in a major Marvel Cinematic Universe project? This is life-altering. It really is. And like, some people have said it before, I really hope that she has a stable stable support for her. I really hope she has some people who will look out for her, who will be by her side, and will, you know, not take advantage of her, because she is so young. I mean, 17 years old, maybe 18, but basically 17 years old. I mean, she's still in high school, but she's from here, so she's still, well, she's from Canada, but I mean, I think the Canada system works very similar to ours, so I'm just gonna say, she's still in high school, man. So, like, you imagine still being in high school and being the lead in one of the biggest fucking, I'm probably not actually in high school, because I mean, but I don't know, she doesn't have any acting credits, so I don't know where she, I don't know what she's been off doing, so maybe she was in high school, but can you imagine that, man? That's so young to be the lead of such a massive project. I just hope that everything goes fine for her, because that shit could go one way or the other. It can end up like Tom Holland, which he took to that shit like a fish in water. I tell you, Tom Holland took to the fucking, to the pressures and to the fucking excitement of being the big next big Spider-Man like a fish to water. Or it can, you know, be self-describing. It can be a lot for someone her age to take in. I just hope it's the latter. I hope it's more of a Tom Holland situation. But thank you guys for joining the Comic Game Movie Show. Please remember to like, subscribe. And what do you think of this? What do you think of this casting? I know you've probably never heard of her before. Neither have I. But like I said, I do think you guys should take to the bank that for a no-name actress to get a role in something like this, and after they've already tried out a bunch of other girls, means that she killed the fucking, she killed the audition. Means that she did so good in the audition that they said, this is it. So I just want you guys to have that in the back of your minds when you, before you comment and before you think about this. She did had such a good audition that they just went, she's it. I don't care what she's worked on. She's our Cap Mark. She's our Ms. Marvel. So thank you guys for coming to Comic Game Movie Show. Please remember to like and subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.